We're going to go further again because these numbers do not really have a pattern. We're going to go further again and find the second difference. What we add to 4 to get 8, definitely the answer is 4. What we add to 8 to get 12, the answer again is 4. We already can pick up a sequence going on there. What we add to 12 to get 16, that is 4. Since these answers are all the same, we call them the second different sequence. Now, what we're going to do here, looking at the following step, we are just going to equate terms. Equate terms to what? We are just going to consider these numbers here and equate the first number here of the second difference to 2a, equates the first number here of our first difference to 3a plus b. So the question is, what we add to 3 to get 7? The answer definitely is 4. What we add to 7 to get 15? The answer definitely is 8. What then we add to 15 to get 27? The answer definitely is 12. And clearly, what then we add to 27 to get 43? That should be 16. So these numbers are known as our first different sequence. So, like we said, 2a equals to that, 3a plus b equals to the first number there, a plus b plus c is equal to the first number there, which is 3. Right, so just like we said, 2a equals to 4, so our goal here is to find a, b, and c. Right, so in order to find a, we need to divide both sides by 2, or, yeah, definitely, so that's divided by 2, and that should give us a to be equals to 2. So now we're going to substitute this into our first different sequence, like we said over there. So the value of a is 2, substituting over here. It gives us 3 into 2 plus b to be equal to 4. That is 6. So that means, and transposing it to the other side of the equation, we have b to be equal to 4. That is 6. So minus, because it's positive, because it's minus 3 into 2. That will give us b to be equal to 4 minus 6, which is negative 2. So now we have our value of a to be 2, our value of b to be equal to negative 2. We're going to substitute that here and there. Remember this is the given sequence. We said a plus b plus c equals to the first number, which was 3 for the given sequence. So now we're going to substitute it there. So substituting, we're going to have a is 2 plus, plus b is negative 2 plus c to be equal to 3. That clearly gives us 0. And so what are we left with? We are left with c to be equal to 3. Now, we are definitely going to substitute all these equations into our nth term because it forms a quadratic sequence. That's our nth term formula is tnb equals to an squared plus bn plus c. Substituting, we have tn to be equals to our value of a is 2, so we have 2n squared. Our value of b is negative 2, so we have minus 2n plus c. Our value of c is 3. So now, let us have to find the nth term of the given sequence that was given. The first thing to do is to make sure that you find the first difference. Since the first difference doesn't have a solid or a constant difference or a constant answer, we go further to find our second difference. Once we realize our second difference has the same answer, which we got to before, we now equate terms. Equating terms basically means that we need to go further. Equating terms basically means that now we say 2a to be equals to 4, 3a plus b equals the first number there, which is 4, And then A plus B plus C equals to 3, which is the first number here. It's just coincidental that we have a 4 and 4 repeating here. All you do is to take the first number and the first number there. Once you are done, because it's following a quadratic sequence, you solve for A in that process. You also solve for B by solving. Fool. So substituting the values of A, we got A to be equals to 2, we got B to be equals to minus 2, and C to be equals to 3 into the nth term. This is our nth term. That gives us the n to be equals to A, which is 2n squared, plus B, which is minus. So that gives minus 2n plus C. C is 3, so plus 3. Definitely the positive and the negative will talk to each. So giving us 2n squared minus 2n plus 3 happens to be our nth term of the quadratic sequence. It is quadratic because we have what? A constant difference, a constant second difference. Hence, that is our final answer we did before. I'm James Sikapoku, and thank you for enjoying and viewing this video. Have a nice day. And thanks to the camera crew, stupid fools.